While interfacing with the Uganda Civil Aviation Authority officials over their budget framework paper for 2023-2024 financial year, MPs expressed concern of safety at the airport, mentioning another recent incident when an Air Rwanda craft ran off the runway.
In terms of civil aviation, I think safety comes first in whatever you do. Safety first. So on that issue, there shouldn't be a discussion. It should just be a matter of implementation. So that area chair, we should make sure that the civil aviation gets whatever they need to make sure that our airport is safe.
Sure, they improve because the taxi airline that landed had the mass emergency landing was as a result of those birds which are in Entebbe. I know there are challenges that those birds, you don't handle them anyhow. Still, the aviation industry will be sued by other agencies, that, like wildlife and so forth. But that's done. That's happening. They must deal with it in a manner which provides security to the people and the aviation industry entire.
While explaining the incident, the Director General of Civil Aviation Authority, Fred Bamwesiji, explained that the incident was caused by the flock of birds which fly to Entebbe during winter. He noted that when the birds hit the aircraft, the plane had to hover around overhead to reduce the weight of fuel. He also blamed the emergency of Rwanda Air for the weakness of the pilot and the flooding runway.
It was raining heavily, if you remember. As soon as it went to the air, then a swarm of birds struck and it sank in some size of a big bird in the swarms. For your information, Honorable Chair, Entebbe is a bird sanctuary. It is known world over because of the environment and the physical features. Birds fly away from winter and come, and among the places they go to is Entebbe.
But legislators insisted that the bird strikes incident was avoidable if the Civil Aviation Authority found a better way to prevent them from interfering with planes while taking off to avoid putting lives at risk.
The authority can see how to manage those birds if possible, because they are a real danger. They are a real danger to safety. But these are rare occurrences.
Okay. Yeah. Meanwhile, the Committee of Physical Infrastructure was shocked to learn that many government agencies which use services of the Civil Aviation Authority have not been paying for a long time. Uganda Civil Aviation Authority is currently demanding 38 government agencies, a tune of 137.9 billion shillings, for using their services and not paying. These agencies include the President's Office, Parliament of Uganda, UPDF, Police, Ministry of Finance, among others.
Are failing to pay. That's a fact. We've seen all the evidence, all correspondence, people are not responding. And MONUSCO, if really government committed to pay, why is government not paying? So, Chair, I also want to move with the rest of the members that these entities, we should interact with these entities one by one, one by one. And if they really fail to do it, let them be published so that we know those who are not paying.
The committee chairperson, David Karubanga, has resolved that they are going to summon all defaulting agencies before the committee to explain why they have failed to pay Uganda Civil Aviation Authority.
They gave us a list of debtors, and in many categories, some of them as government agencies, some of them foreign bodies. But what I would like as a committee is to make sure that that money due to CAA is paid. They told us they at one time engaged a debt collector, but the efforts did not yield much. But as a committee, of course, we have resolved, we want to call all these agencies to make sure they budget for the money.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.